commencement of Glasgow High School and the class of 2022. I remind you that this entire program is being professionally photographed and videotaped and is playing live right now as we speak on our YouTube channel, where it will be housed forever, so you will forever have a memory of this evening. So please, with that being said, do not come onto the floor to take any pictures. So at this time, if everyone would please rise. Ladies and gentlemen, led by our valedictorian, salutatorian, senior class officers, senior class advisor, Ms. Amina Mathias, teacher of the year of 2022-23, Mr. Larry Isaacoff, and members of our distinguished faculty and guests. Will you please remain standing for the presentation of our colors by the Glasgow AFJORTC and our Star Spangled Banner being performed by none other than Grace Nadorsay.
Thank you.
Let's give it up one more time for Grace and the Dorse and the AFJROTC of Glasgow High School. You may be seated. As we proceed this evening, I just want to again remind families, the students and staff have worked hard to persevere the dignity of this ceremony. So I ask for your cooperation in preserving this dignity of the evening's program. I remind all guests that tonight's commencement is a formal ceremony, and please, please act accordingly. So please silence your phones and refrain from any noises that may detract from this ceremony, because everyone wants to hear their child's name called. My turn now, I guess. So friends and family, distinguished guests, if you did not know, I am Butch Ingram, and it gives me great honor to stand before you this evening as the principal of Glasgow High School. Thank you. I appreciate it. At this time, I would like to honor some of our distinguished guests that are here on stage. And as I call your name, please stand and remain standing until everyone has been recognized. Audience, I please ask that you hold your applause until everyone has been announced. Dr. Deirdre Joyner, Deputy Superintendent, Chief Academic Officer. Ms. Christine MacBerry, Principal of Sarah, if you're coming in a little bit later. I would also like to recognize any retired or active members of the military. If you are in the audience, if you would please stand, you definitely deserve a round of applause. Thank you very much, and we appreciate your service. I would also like to recognize student leaders for the class of 2022. As I call your name, would you also please stand? And everyone, please hold your applause until they are all announced. Valedictorians, Sarah Kasim, Jada Turner. So much for that. We're gonna have fun, it's okay, it's all right. Salutatorian, Abigail Adene, I'm sorry. Senior class president, Makai Lloyd. Senior class vice president, Chanel Jones-Hill. Secretary, Leah Khaleesi. And treasurer, Jayla Chambers Glover. Our student leaders for class of 2022. You may be seated, thank you very much. Lots of recognitions, because this is an awesome year, so please bear with us. I would like to recognize this year's Teacher of the Year, Ms. April Simmons, and this upcoming Teacher of the Year, Mr. Larry Isakoff, if you could please stand. The entire Glasgow High School staff and team, would you please stand and give a round of applause, because you are one of the reasons that we are able to be here this evening. I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge these two individuals who are my partners and colleagues and are always there to pick up the ball when I drop it and are here to support Glasgow High School. If Ms. Pauline Hurst and Ms. Christine Gatugi, if you are somewhere in here, can you please stand and be recognized? They're right there in the back. Students, it's our turn to recognize a very special group of people. These people have supported and guided you to this milestone in your life and your family. Would the students, would you please rise and give a big round of applause for all of your family and community here that is here to support you. Students, please stand and recognize them. Give them a round of applause. They did awesome. All right. Thank you very much. You may be seated. At this time, I would like to introduce a woman who has left her mark on generations of
graduating dragons of the class of 2022. Yeah, give him a hand, that's right. As deputy super, your parents have helped you, encouraged you, and loved you unconditionally, and our many talented teachers and staff have helped you to discover your capabilities. And although you are moving beyond this school, those same staff members will remember your journey. To the parents out there of our graduating seniors, words cannot express our deepest appreciation and gratitude for your continued support and involvement in our school. I believe that what sets Glasgow apart from all schools is the active involvement and intense care that you invest in our young people and staff. Thank you for sharing your most precious possession, your children, and for entrusting us with their education and personal development. We know that it truly takes a village to help raise our young people. So in addition to our parents, I want to ask all grandparents of the 2022 graduating class to please stand. All grandparents of our 2022 graduating class. I even see some t-shirts out there. We know that many of you, along with their parents, you started it all. So we salute you because this is your legacy. Yeah, give those grandparents another hand. Many of you have guided and shaped the class of 2022, and your role has been instrumental. To the graduating dragons, I wish you luck as you go on your way. I trust you will make the most of the opportunities you have been given and with the knowledge you have gained in this school, the guidance of your family, and the beautiful friendships you have made. I am confident that you will find success and happiness. As you continue on your path, remember that this journey is not only about you, it is also about the impact you will make on the world. Glasgow will always be a guiding star for you, and it will always be your home.
Thank you, Dr. Joyner. At this time, I would ask that you please join me in welcoming the president of the Christina School District Board of Education, Dr. Keeley Powell.
Good evening, families and guests and the class of 2022. I'm honored to be here this evening to represent the Christina School District Board of Education. Now, I'm going to keep these remarks brief because I know that this is you. Students, today is your graduation day, and it marks the first day of your next chapter. And what a journey this has been. Your class started high.
This is the part in the program where it says that we are to have a musical selection, but unfortunately, the word I'm about to share, in its place, I'm going to lead us in song. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to do that. I know you would want me to do that, but I'm definitely not going to lead us to all of that. So at this time, please, please, please join me in welcoming the class of 2022 salutatorian, Miss Abigail, as she shares her reflections to the graduating class.
Thank you, Mr. Ingram. Good evening, parents, families, friends, teachers, and my wonderful fellow graduates. My name is Abigail Adeneye. It is with great pleasure that I stand here before you as the salutatorian for the class of 2022. Anyone who knows me knows that I'm a quiet kid, and that standing up here to give the speech is not an easy thing for me to do. I have summoned all this courage to stand up here because I have an important message. As Bedouis once said, if you think you're too small to be effective, you have never been in the dark with a mosquito. I remember when I first started high school, with no one to call my friend. I felt lonely, and for someone like me who was always quiet, it was quite hard to make friends. As days turned into months and months turned into years, I came to realize what amazing people I had been surrounded by. People who I could call my friends and family, who made high school a fond memory for me. Now I know that as I think of my high school days, there will always be when things go well, pay extra attention when they don't, and watch how people react to it. Build relationships with the people who face problems by being the solution. And as talk show host Ellen once said, follow your passion, stay true to yourself, never follow someone else's path, unless you're in the woods and you're lost and you see a path. Then by all means, you should follow that. We all have different experiences. For me, my experience was life-changing. I moved to the US about 3 years ago, from the education system to the government to the lifestyle, everything was different. Just like I have been able to grow from this experience, but we know any of this is possible. I sit back and I reminisce on the challenges that have only made us the stronger person that we are today. Each challenge has been a stepping stone to get us right here in this moment, and we take it somewhere higher in the future. As the salutatorian for the class of 2022, I salute every graduate here today for getting your diploma. I salute you for getting past Mrs. Mathias's math class. That was a true definition of struggle. I salute you for slaying on prom night. Everyone looked gorgeous. I salute the amazing families here tonight supporting us that have helped us through our struggles at Glasgow High School, and hopefully will continue even after high school. And last but not least, I salute each of you for never giving up yourself and your family proud. And now I say thank you. Thank you to all of my friends who have made my stay at Glasgow a fun journey. Thank you to all of our teachers for caring about us, for your guidance, your words, support, and the memories that we have made. Thank you to my family for always sticking with me through the good and not so good times. On behalf of all the graduates, I say thank you to those who have positively impacted our lives. And finally, let's thank ourselves for all our hard work and determination. It is because of us that we're here today. I know that these past few months have been hard on all of us because of the pandemic. We cried, we laughed, we loved, we bonded, and now we celebrate. Not just the end of a journey, but the beginning of a new one. Thank you.
Let's give Miss Abigail another round of applause. Excellent job. Now, when I started, I promised that I was going to stay on script. But my class knows me. So as we move throughout the program, there may be some variations, so I don't want you to be surprised. I want you to embrace it. But one of the first things I want us to do is I want this to be a celebration of the class of 2022. So I'm going to try this and hope that it works. So I need everybody's participation when we do this, because this is about this group of people right here in front of me. So when I say G, I want everybody in here to say hi. Can we do that? G!
Hi.
G! All right, so periodically I may say that throughout there, because I just want to feel the love and the energy that we have for everybody here. And one more thing I want to try. I'm going to say we are, and we're going to say 22 for the class of 22. Can we do that also? Let's try it. We are? I don't feel that. I want to hear this at TGI Fridays across the street. We are? There we go. So I'm going to do this periodically, and there might be something else, so just stay tuned. But at this time, I would like to welcome one of two of our valedictorians for this year. At this time, I would like Miss Sarah Kasim, would you please come to the podium?
Good evening, everyone. It is an honor to stand before you all today at Glasgow High School Class of 2022 Valedictorian. I know that all of you are excited to walk up the stage and receive your high school diploma. I want to show appreciation for the people who helped me throughout this journey to achieve my dream to become a class valedictorian. So I want to thank the following people who supported and contributed to my success today. To my grandpa Ahmed, thank you for bringing my family to America and giving my family the chance to receive a great education. Amazing aunt, Nadia, there has never been an aunt like you. One part mother and one part friend. You are truly one of the greatest gifts in my life. Thank you so much. Love you more. To my aunt, Aisha, thank you for your support and great memories. To my grandpa, Fe, thank you so much for everything. There are infinite things I can thank you for. And to our family genius, Grandma Amira, she's not here, but I know she will be watching this, my speech. I want to say that this person I look up to for an advice and wisdom, and the greatest teacher of all time who has the patience and passion and dedication for kids. Love you. My mom, my beautiful, amazing mom. My mom is one of kind women. She gave me life, nurtured me, educated me, clothed me, assisted me, yelled at me, and kissed me. But most importantly, she loved me unconditionally. There aren't enough words to express how important my mother is to me and how powerful she has been and continues to be. Finally, I want to share some advice with the class of 2022. While the school years may end, there are always more opportunities to grow and learn. So never stop learning. Work hard all the time because your work will eventually pay off. Because this has been my dream, and I worked hard for the past 4 years to become the valedictorian of class of 2022. Life is tough, so no matter how much you fall, always remember there is a dream waiting for you to accomplish. To my fellow graduates, today is your day. Celebrate with friends and family, and let that memory of today last forever. Thank you.
Let's give Sarah another round of applause. Excellent job on her speech. Let me test this. G! I told you I was gonna do this. I need your help. G! All right. Next up, valedictorian number two, Miss Jada Turner.
Thank you, Mr. Ingram, for that introduction. Good evening to the Christiana School District Board members, administration, staff, and Glasgow High School administration, and staff. Greetings, family, friends, loved ones, and of course, the reason we're all here, hey, class of 2022. My name is Jaya Turner. I have the great honor of being Glasgow's valedictorian. It has been an interesting 4 years at Glasgow. Since our freshman year, when we were nervous or excited to start high school, having our sophomore year cut short due to a global pandemic, a junior year only being online, to finally having one last normal school year. Despite online learning, computers not loading, Schoology going down when we were about to submit our work before 11:59 p.m., and wanting to just give up altogether, we survived. Even though seniorized hit us hard, we still finish. High school has come to an end for us. We have persevered through the hard times of having tough teachers, losing sports games, stressed out catching up on classwork, and trying to maintain a social life. While half of our high school career was taken over by the pandemic, we displayed tenacity. When I found out that I was going to be valedictorian, I had to make a speech, I was lost. Lost about what to say, if I should just fill it with stereotypical cliches that we all hear in these kinds of speeches. But I thought, why not start with thank you? Thank you to the family, friends, and loved ones who have been the greatest support system through all of this. Staying up, reading over papers for any typos or any grammatical errors, staying on FaceTime with us to hold each other accountable to finish our work, and supporting each other through any mental health challenges that we were going through. Thank you to the teachers that have challenged us, believed in us, who led us in classrooms to calm ourselves down when we were having one of those days, and for not giving up on us when we were ready to give up on ourselves. Also, thank yourselves. Thank yourself for staying on top of things, getting out of bed when you didn't want to, coming to school in the midst of a global pandemic, wearing a mask, turning in that missing assignment just in the nick of time, and for staying true to yourself. While we are taking the time to say thank you, I want to thank my family for being there for me and believing in me when I didn't believe in myself. Thank you to my friends for going through these last 4 years with me and as we helped each other to grow and support one another. You have made these last 4 years memorable. And finally, I thank the teachers that have watched me grow from being a shy, closed-off freshman to the senior that served as homecoming queen, captain of the field hockey team, and now valedictorian. I hope you guys enjoyed the view. Last but not least, thank you Glasgow High School for teaching us lessons that we didn't learn in the classrooms, like how to navigate through relationships, losing friends, gaining new ones, and that we are going to mess up, and it's okay. And how to figure out who we are as individuals, which we are all still trying to figure out. Now that this chapter is ending, and we are starting the next phase of our lives, remember to stay true to who you are. Don't let others tell you differently. Don't be afraid to stand up for yourself, and don't allow people to treat you less than, because trust me, there will be haters, and this is your chance to prove them wrong, period. Remember, you control the narrative. I want to finish with a quote by Sean Combs that goes, "I don't say it in a cocky way, but I take pride in being one of the best at what I do." Thank you.
Let's give it up for Jada Turner. Three outstanding representatives of the senior class. On June 9th, we held our senior award ceremony. Many students were recognized for their accomplishments, and many of these honors are highlighted in this evening's program. Would all the students who receive recognition during senior awards please stand and be recognized? Let's give them a round of applause.
Good evening. On behalf of the class of 2022, I would like to welcome all distinguished guests, faculty, family, and friends to Glasgow High School's 47th commencement ceremony. I would like to begin by congratulating the class of 2022. We did it. G-High, but to the seniors in the stands as well, you also did it. Before I begin, I would like to give a few special shout outs. I would like to thank each and every one of you who has stuck beside us through this rough and confusing high school journey. One of major many milestones we have to look forward to in life. Each one of you has played a part in molding us into becoming the intelligent, independent, strong-willed, and determined young adults you see sitting in front of you today. You have given us the strength and courage to conquer any obstacle laid upon our path. You have never allowed us to quit, and by never quitting, we will forever win. And for that, we thank you. To Mr. Ingram, Ms. Gatugi, Ms. Hurst, and to the members of Christina School District's Board of Education, I would like to thank you. It has been an honor to not only serve as a member of my school student government association as class president, but also the alternate representative for the district student council. You all have unleashed a hidden talent I didn't know I possessed, which was advocating on behalf of others. You have encouraged me to not only use my boldness as a power to push and uplift others, but to also advocate for them as well. Being a part of these groups has taught me leadership and communication skills I will forever use in life. They will come in handy as I continue to further my education in criminal justice and sociology in hopes of becoming a civil rights and criminal defense lawyer. Last but not least, I would like to dedicate a special shout out to one of GHI's best teachers. This teacher has not only stuck beside me since day one, but has guided me in an all-around better direction of life. She has told me that no matter how big the boulder that is lodged upon your path may be, it is up to you to hide behind that boulder or come out and face it like the underdog, the one many thought wouldn't make it. This teacher has not only become an educator, she has become a mentor, a motivator, a leader, a friend, and what some might call a big homie to any student she has come in contact with here at GHI. I would like to thank Ms. Nathaniel Speaks for always encouraging us to overreach in life, to push ourselves further, and to never give up. We appreciate and love you, Tandy Tan. Like many of you know, these past 4 years have been extremely stressful and confusing. I believe I can speak for the entire class and stands when I say I did not expect high school to unfold this way. We can say that we still don't understand how Y equals MX plus B is going to help us within our everyday life, but we cannot say we did not come out stronger. Think about it. This past 4 years as a whole, we have had to face a worldwide pandemic, political protests and disagreements, mass shootings, brutal attacks, racial inequalities, and don't forget about those high gas prices. All joking aside, this season of our lives has not been easy. As some of you may know, I myself experienced major adversity and difficulties throughout my high school experience. I had a life-threatening infection where I spent over a month in a hospital undergoing multiple procedures and hours of physical therapy. The following year, on February 5th, 2020, I was separated from my family and placed in a foster care system. Shortly after, my aunt, who was special to me, passed away from a battle with stage 4 cancer. She was the backbone of my family. She was the protector, bold but kind-hearted, the most loyal and genuine person you could ever come in contact with. Before her passing, I promised her one thing: I would walk across this stage. I became angry, lost with feelings of hopelessness. I didn't think I would make it. I'm finally able to say, I in fact made it. I share all of that to say, if I can do it, anyone under the sound of my voice, young or old, can do anything you set your mind to. After today, some of us still may not know where we want to head in life. Some of us still may not have decided on what college we want to attend or what career we wish to embark on. We may not know if we're doing everything perfectly, and all of that is okay. Life is all about change and challenge. It is up to each of you to decide to play the hand you were dealt. It's a winning hand. As Ms. Speaks always says, you can either hide behind your problems, allowing them to hold you down, or you can use them as a stepping stone, learning the lessons and using them as motivation to take you higher. All things good and bad work to push us to purpose. Each one of you in front of me has a hidden talent that you may not even know you have. From this moment forward, it is time to find what your talent is and use it to make a mark on this world. Get away from people that aren't trying to better themselves. Get away from people that are afraid to chase their dreams. Get away from people that drain the energy out of you, that won't allow you to prosper. There is a quote by Steve Harvey that I've recently started to live by, and it states, God has already lined up all the people in your path to get you to your dreams and visions. All you have to do is get rid of the wrong ones. Graduates, graduates, you are all destined for greatness. You have all grown into powerful, intelligent individuals who will make a massive footprint in this world. As we part ways, equipped with knowledge, which is power, we embark on a life filled with challenges and success. Always remember this, life is not easy. Everything worth it requires hard work. No one owes you anything. Always be appreciative. Always choose kindness and empathy. Find love and love well. And in the moments love hurts or may seem hard to find, know that you will always be loved here at G-High. Congratulations, class of 2022. We finally made it.
Let's give it up for Makai Lloyd, senior class president. I guess I don't have anything else to say after that. But I do realize I'm the one standing between you and that over there to my right. So I'll do my best to share some things that I think that I'm qualified to share as you are officially about to be graduates of Glasgow, but you are we have spent the last 4 years together, started and ended this journey. So I would like to extend a warm welcome once again on behalf of Glasgow High School, its faculty and staff, to this wonderful celebration of these students' accomplishments. Let's give them one more round of applause for Glasgow class of 2022. As the principal, it goes without saying that I'm completely aware and empathetic to the difficulties you have endured over the last 4 years. I know it wasn't easy, but you did it. It gives me, personally, tremendous pleasure to speak to this class because we are graduating today. We have faced many adversities together. Together, we have been on this adventure for the last 4 years. We battled 2 years of uncertainty with the COVID-19 pandemic, quarantined, and yet still together. Together, we suffered a great loss in one of our dear faculty members in Ms. Rebecca Henderson. We endured growing pains as we housed many organizations and gained wonderful new roommates that are now the district office as they have moved in with us. Together, we survived the unfavorable news coverage that attempted to make us out to be something that we are not. Their perception is not our reality. No matter what the obstacles or challenges we face together, we are still here, stronger, wiser, and more driven than ever, charged to make a difference in this world, because we are the class of 2022. So, since I feel like I'm actually graduating with you, let me tell you what I've learned from you. You have taught me to never judge a book by its cover, because Lord knows, when I came on August 27, 2018, I said, what did I sign up for? But as a result, I've had the privilege and honor of learning and growing aside some of the most incredible set of young adults I have ever met. You have taught me that in times of hardships, uncertainty, struggle, that I must continue to show up and stay committed no matter what. How did you show me this? I'm glad you asked me that. You demonstrated this when you were hammering on the front door of the school at 7:05, demanding that I hurry up and open the door and get to my duty post. Despite this, you continued to return even on days when we were off. The final and most significant lesson that you taught me is threefold: love, humility, and respect. We've had our share of disagreements over the last 4 years. And while we always didn't agree, because of course you think you know it all, we've learned to value each other's opinions, respect each other's feelings, and ultimately have a genuine care and concern for one another. And for this, I am glad and will be forever grateful to this class of 2022. So that's enough about me as we move on. This is about you. Quote, challenges are what make life interesting, and overcoming them is what make life meaningful. This year, these years, have definitely been one for the books. You as seniors have faced your own set of challenges and experiences, but you should know that you are not alone in your learning. You are preparing for the next chapter, arrived daily over the last 4 years, ready to learn and grow. You may not realize this, but you are instrumental in the education of others, your teachers, peers, friends, family, and as stated before, myself. We've learned a lot over the last 4 years, and we are grateful to have that opportunity with you. Your attendance at Glasgow High School has demonstrated your commitment, your tenacity, and your respect for education. It demonstrates that you alone can establish and achieve goals when engaged in things that challenge you. You have been able to establish principles that were instilled by your parents and teachers. You are consistently there, eager to learn, and even though some days are more challenging than others, your work ethic, and determination have helped you to succeed and bring you to this point. Have pride in that. Nelson Mandela was quoted as saying, "Education is the most potent weapon you can deploy to change the world." Each of you have been committed to achieving academic success and have the power to make a difference, especially in this broken world. You may not think that someone like you can make a difference, but you can. Do not dwell at this moment on things that you are about to leave behind as you begin this new chapter of your life. Be grateful for your friendships you've made and the connections you have established. Move forward with an open mind and heart, and make room in your story for new characters. It's absolutely up to you where you go from here. The options before you are unlimited. You are only limited by your imagination. You will leave here with confidence, courage, respect, and a sense of direction. You have worked hard to get here, and now the doors are open. Go through and don't look back unless it is to help someone that is coming up behind you. Take advantage of every opportunity, and always, always continue to do your best. You have the ability to dream anything you want, so why not have your dreams turn into reality? So I encourage you to go get it. And at some point over the past 4 years, I'm sure you have thought it's impossible, but it's not. You have succeeded. You are your greatest advocate, and always remember that. So what's next? What are you expected to do? It is up to you to decide. You are entering adulthood with new perspectives into a new world. Consider and appreciate all of those who have gone before you and learn from their experiences. Continue putting forth effort, roll up your sleeves, and get to work. Become a lifelong learner and enjoy discovering new things. Achieve, achieve, and achieve, and always expect results. In closing, the final quote that I would like to give to you is, jump off the cliff and learn how to make wings on the way down. Now understand, I'm not telling you to literally jump off the cliff. But what I'm telling you is to never wait until something seems to work or come together. Just begin and make it happen. Start, and while in the process, you will begin to make it work and manifest towards your goals. So while I'm confined to the Bob, we can't have a DJ, We're not free to do those things that we were able to do last year on the football field. I think we can still turn up. So before we do that, let's do my quick call and response as we're getting close to time. And I know that my boss is behind me. It's like, hurry up with it. Keep it moving. Let's start with it. G! G! We are? I don't hear my class. You guys, what are we doing? We are? I think your parents are more excited than you, but that's all right. All right, so turn up is a little different, but here we go. In closing, the T for turn up is take your time. Life is a process. Learn as much as you can. The U is for uniqueness. You are special, and there is no one like you. Be and always be yourself. The R is for respect for yourself and others. Your actions absolutely define you. The N is to never forget. Never forget those who loved you, who support you, and have helped you along the way. And the U is for unwavering. Never give up. Keep going, even when life is hard. And finally, the P. Most importantly, the P. Pay attention. You are a product of what and who you surround yourself. I thank you very much for this opportunity to address you all. I have no doubt that you will do incredible and amazing things. You are the class of 2022. Please join me in welcoming the senior class vice president, Ms. Chanel Jones-Hill, who will give a few remarks, and then we will present the class of 2022.
Okay, before we get to the presentation of the class, I just want to again congratulate the class of 2022. Congrats, y'all. First, I'd like to thank Mr. Ingram for sticking it out these last 4 years with us. It's been wonderful. Glasgow is a school filled with kids that possess many different talents and young advocates. Despite the rumors and bad talk about Glasgow, this school has brought up some pretty successful students, all with the help of the staff. We all here to talk about how one school is better than the other, but why? Because they have more stuff or a bigger environment. Expensive things or better equipment isn't what makes the school great. It's the staff, but most importantly, it's the students. Being a teacher sometimes can get tough, but when you have a set of great students, the job isn't just a job anymore. It's a home where everyone feels comfortable enough to share their stories with the teachers they love most, or crack jokes on a staff in a hallway just because they're there. Just like if you were home and needed some space to yourself, you'd go to your room, but in this case, your room was the teacher you trusted the most. My room was with Ms. Speaks. I could come to her for anything or even ask her for anything. Ms. Speaks is one of the best teachers we have here at Glasgow. Not just a teacher, but a mentor, a friend, a therapist, and over time, a parent. I've actually been mistaken for her daughter a couple times. That's how much time we spent together. School is about getting an education, but it's also about building relationships, because what fun is it to go to school if you have to be serious all the time? We have Miss Mathias for that, always about the book. Don't get me wrong, though, she loves a good hood jam. Not to mention Baldy. I mean Mr. Peterson. I remember the volleyball team got stranded one night, and he came out his way to assist in taking some of the ladies home with the help of some of the staff and some other parents and coaches. That's dedication to the students right there, and for that, I thank him. Members of the board, guests, parents, and friends, it is my pleasure to present to you the students who have successfully completed the requirements for graduation from Glasgow High School. I proudly present class of 2022.
Thank you. One more round of applause for Ms. Chenille, Senior Class Vice President. It's about that time. Once again, I remind you that this ceremony is videotaped and a professional photographer will take an individual photo of each graduate. We ask that all photographs are not taken from the floor after the awarding of the diplomas. Glasgow High School staff, Ms. Lelina Arevalo, Lisa Aquat, and Felicia Stone-Jones will be calling individual members of the graduating class. Dr. Joyner and members of the Christina School District Board of Education, I hereby certify that all the students assembled before you this evening have successfully completed the requirements for diplomas from the state of Delaware in the Christina School District. Ms. Rowe.
Jayla Chambers Glover, Leah Khaleesi, Chenille Jones Hill, Makai Lloyd, Abigail Adeneye,
Sarah Kasim,
Jada Turner. Christian Arana, James Atkins, Christian Avila, Amir Bacon, Dylan Blackburn, AJ Boganil, Latwood Brooks, David Carino, Everardo Constantino Rojas, Gabriel Aven Curls, Huraya Abduz Shahid, Janissa Amos. Who is? Nayana Alston. Nakaya Argun Peters. Conchera Biden. Cynthia Banda. Tiana Barnes, Jaylene Brown, Alexia Burnett, Alice Bush Robinson, Elijah Davis, Giancarlo DeLeon, Angel Gabriel Nava, Austin Dotson, Charles Chukwemeka Elazu, Christopher Sean Estorel, Aaron Estorel. Darren Gambrell. Edwin Garcia Ibarra. Jesus Emiliano Gomez Gutierrez. Jasmine Cabrera Garcia. Charney Carter. Melissa Chansurilla. Kayla Clayton. Sierra Amonay Coleman. Lalisha Kaufman. Alisa Cruz. Elsa Cruz. Kamaya Dursey. Citlali Dorantes.
John Green III. Ivan Gutierrez Cabrera. Naeem Shakur Hall. Jaheim Hamilton.
Kevin Nicolas Hernandez Grullon.
Daniel Edward Johnson. Metro Jerome Jones III. Kirk Knox Jr. Anthony Howard Lewis Jr. Carlos Laredo. Johnny Marie Harris. Adriana Harris. Janasia Grasty.
Maria del Carmen Gonzalez. Destiny Garcia.
I don't have all the names.
Chantal Antonella Beatriz Garcia Cruz. Yaracet Flores. Garian Ewing. Perla Escobar Rubalcaba. Montilla Dupree Walker.
Michael Ludke. Deshaun Mathias. Gavin Brian Moore. Shane Moore.
Giovanni Morales Martinez. Alex Alan Moratin Pantoja.
Tyler Island Moats.
Milo Richardson. Joshua Matthew Phillip. Aaron James Pinkston Jr.
Dariana Jackson. Dominique Zola Johnson. Ashley Julian. Alessandrini Lane. Kiana Lewis.
Kelly Michelle Lopez.
Maya Mason. Imani Renee Matos. Naya Lorraine Marabella.
Amy Moreno.
Avion Quails. Chris Robinson.
Brian Saldivar Vasquez. Carlos Segura Ortiz.
Thomas Shipley.
Hector Solano Bustos.
Makai Sparks. Kevon Stewart. Ronald John Stowe Jr. Hamid Ahmad Sanzar. Michaela Roundtree.
Vanessa San Pedro Gonzalez.
Yeah.
Nasaria Morse Hill. Marasia Mosby. Olivia Murphy.
Anaya Pearson. Michaela DeAsia Monique Pearson. Gianni Peterson. Quayana Pleasant. Brooke Elaine Primaldi. Jeffrey Martin Taylor III. Dante Christopher Thompson. Xavier Thompson.
Alexander Torres. Jonathan Torres Zúñiga. Axel Trejo Ugalde. José Carlos Villagómez Grant. Juan Carlos Villarini González.
Tajir Ramon Washington. Roman Vincent Taylor. Amy Lee Wadolny. Joey Marie Elizabeth Walker. Shanice Shanae White.
Divine Palumi Olasubomi.
Malaya Pritchard. Muscown Ruff. Rebecca Rice.
Johanna Romero Santiago.
Daisha Roundtree. My baby. Brian Wright. Nicholas Waldridge. Aiden Bryce White. Ayer White. Verdine Marie White Jr. Tymir Wilson. Willie Wilson Jr. Tavon Ernest Yancey. Kanye Yates. Derek Uyu.
Daniel Zavala Rosiles. Yaritza Rivera.
Sorry, I got it. Olivia Wright. Skyla Sprill. Amira Wilson. Alicia Sanchez.
Virginia Alejandra Sanchez Perez.
Lacey, Jasmine Tilden. Jasmine Lacey Tilden.
Vanciel. Amari Vanciel Shaw. Sydney Sutton. Jada Thomas Glanton. Jasmine Lacey Tilden. Hail.
Okay. So you got that. You got it.
Jasmine Lacey Tilden Hales.
Hales.
I've never had it not be alphabetical before. I don't know what that was.
So Small change, but we're still rolling. No worries. I need the first two rows to kind of come back up real quick because you guys did not get your picture because the photographer was not there. We want the first two rows to make sure they get an opportunity to get that picture. Come this way. Just come up. Just walk right here and just come straight through and we'll just go right through. Sorry about that, friends and family, but we do want to make sure every student does get the opportunity to get that picture. All right, thank you for your cooperation and thank you for your patience. We appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2022, let's give it up for them. That's what I'm talking about. Energy, energy, energy. Love it, love it. All right, as we proceed to move forward with closing out here this evening, I need to welcome our senior class secretary and treasurer who will lead in the tassel ceremony, Miss Leah Khaleesi and Jayla Chambers Glover.
Can I get a selfie with the class of 2022 real quick? Okay.
All right, Ms. Khaleesi and Chambers Glover. Students, if you would just please remain standing, and if everyone in the arena would please rise at this time as we are playing our Glasgow High School alma mater. Thank you. So, this is the moment that I know all of you have been waiting for, slightly early. Just hold it for a second, hold it together, and then you'll have every opportunity if you choose to. So class of 2022, are you ready? By the power vested in me by the state of Delaware as the principal of Glasgow High School and in the witness of the presentation of diplomas, I hereby declare that you are now official graduates of Glasgow High School. I knew it was coming. Congratulations, congratulations. Family and guests, we ask that you please remain in the stands until all the graduates have exited the arena. After all graduates have left, they will be exiting on the north side. They are not returning to the building. So when you exit up and go out, families, they will meet you outside on the north side, which is this side of the building. You will find your student there, and they will be ready to receive you. At this time, Glasgow staff, if you would please lead our graduates from the arena. Thank you very much for coming out tonight. Have a wonderful evening. Matthias, that way. First row to the right, follow out.